good to be here. So I'm going to do something called looping. I'm going to explain it to you. I'm going to record a track, and then I play it back, and I record on top of that. And then I play that back, and record on top of that, and play that back, and record on top of that. So everything's happening live in the moment. No pre-recorded tracks. And then at the end, it's very much like a sand mandala. I just erase it. Turn your light. Thank you so much. So, I haven't been here in a while, and I'm really glad to be back. And I know we're doing a live webcast tonight, so there's people out there watching as well. We are numbered here, but we are many more out there. And I've taken some requests online, and this one goes out to my friend Jade Wa'u Gregory in Sedona, Arizona. It's called the Lonely Lion Song. Is anybody here somebody who ever lived in New York City? Yeah? Where did you live? Anybody else? No, you're the only, you and me are the only ones. Anybody visited New York? Okay, great, lots of you. And the rest of you have heard of it? Great. I didn't know that, Betsy. So of those of you who have been there, who has been to the Central Park Zoo? Excellent, okay. So you can be my witnesses. The Central Park Zoo is very small, yes? Okay, they're saying yes. So I was driving up to the Catskills with my friend Sarah. Sarah's a New Yorker through and through. She's got the accent and everything. And she was talking about the Central Park Zoo, and she said, that zoo is so small. Thank you. That zoo is so small that there's only one lion. One lonely, lonely lion. She went on and on about the lion. So I went to the Central Park Zoo and I met the lonely lion. And I wrote this song. And it ended up being about being single in New York City. Yes. And going to the Central Park Zoo and seeing all the happy couples. And trying not to curse them. I'm sitting lonely in the Central Park Zoo. There's nothing I can do to change my tone. I'm watching couples as they play in the park. They stay till it gets dark, then go home. Well, I am watching them, but they don't notice me till they want me to take their picture with the lion. And when they get their film back, they'll be surprised to see just a close-up of the lonely lion crying. There's only one.
There's another lonely lion
If we chance to meet again, I'd be his wife. We still remember the time when we used to run free before we were taken from each other. And if we make it back, oh, how happy we would be. We would run and jump and play, and we would tumble. Familiar faces, and I know some of you have been with me before. Is there anything that you would like to hear live before the end of the night? Any requests that I know? Dr. Bronner's makes your hoo-hoo tingle. Yeah, trees breathe. Okay, anything else? I'll have to take Everyday Goddess, all right? I'll have to take that up with the Trestlefoot Fairy. Okay, we'll always sing. Got it. Anything else? Women with Wings? Okay. I'll do what I can. I got a lot of other people requesting things from online, too, so I'll see what I can make happen there. And if you think of something else and there's a lull, by all means, shout it out, and we'll see what can happen. So right now, I'm going to do none of those. This is by request. This goes out to Pat in Sheboygan, Wisconsin. It's called The Fields of Athenry. It's one of my favorite Irish songs. And Pat, since last time you saw me, I've started doing this song as a looped song, so I'm going to add a lot more layers. My lonely prison wall, I heard a young girl Rebellion's core.
Oh,